In this video, I want to explain to you what is water quality index. I will explain it in such a simplest way that you can even explain it to a child or to an old man who does not even know what it is before. So, water quality index, also known as WQI. So, water quality index is a crucial tool used to assess the health of water bodies by converting complex water quality into a single understandable number. So it is essentially a tool used to assess and monitor or analyze water quality data. Now, before we move further, let's understand how it all started. Why do we use water quality index? Now, for example, let's assume that I have these three water source labeled site 1, site 2, site 3, and I collect sample from these three sites and analyze it. So that's the starting point, collecting samples from different water source. Then the steps in obtaining water quality data from the samples collected is this. Number one is collection of water samples from that different water source. Then I will transport the sample to the lab. Then in the lab, the water will be analyzed for different parameters selected. Then as a result of that, there will be result of the various parameters that are under investigations. So you can see the sequence. You collect sample, then you transport it to the laboratory, you analyze it and get your analytical results. So after you get the analytical results, now the results you will get will be based on the parameters under investigation. For example, let's say these are the parameters we are interested in. These are the physicochemical parameters you want to analyze for your water. So these parameters can vary from one study to another depending on your interest or the objective of your study. So, but for the purpose of this explanation, let's say these are the parameters we are interested in to analyze for. After analyzing for all these parameters, let's assume that this is the result we got for all the parameters. For site 1, these are the results. Site 2, these are the results. And for site 3, these are the results for all the parameters we've selected. However, if you look at this analytical result, you will see that it's too complex for us to understand or interpret at a glance. For example, if I say total dissolved substance value for site 1 is 164 milligram per liter, then what does that mean? So it will be very complex for me just at a glance, or for a layman at a glance, to interpret or understand what this analytical result means in terms of water quality. So therefore, this is why water quality index comes in, to make it easy for us to understand at a glance and give us a better understanding of water quality. Now, an example, after analyzing for water quality index, this is an example of the result you will get. So, such that the result you get for water quality index will fall, depending on the method you use, will fall within the range of water quality index of the method you use. And as a result of that, you'll be able to interpret the water quality status as being excellent, good, poor, very poor, and or unfit for consumption. So, now, what is water quality index? So, water quality index was first developed by Hutton in 1965. And the objective or the purpose of water quality index is to transform complex water quality data into simple information that can easily be understood by anybody or the general public. So as shown you before, when you have the analytical data of water analysis, it is very difficult and hard to understand at a glance or interpret. But with water quality index, it transforms the water quality data into simple information that can easily be understood by anybody or general public. So now, water quality index expresses the overall water quality of water sample being investigated. So water quality index is the tool that expresses the overall water quality of any sample of water being investigated. And the result of water quality index tells us whether the water is fit for drinking purpose or is unfit for drinking. And the water quality status from water quality index can be described as being excellent, good, poor, very poor, or unfit for consumption. That also depends on the method you use for calculating water quality index. Now, how does water quality index being achieved, or what are the processes that leads to water quality index? Generally, water quality index, it summarizes and simplify raw analytical data. Remember, when you analyze for water quality, for example, when you analyze for some parameters of water sample, the water quality index will summarize all the value you got. For example, pH, ion, TDS, and the likes. So the water quality index will summarize all the values and simplify the raw analytical data to produce a single value. So this single value that it produces is the water quality index. And as a result of that, you can now categorize the water quality index into different categories. For example, as being excellent, good, or poor, based on the method you use. So, these are the list of water quality index method we have. Number one, we have the weighted arithmetic index method. Number two, we have the Canadian Council of Ministers of the Environment Water Quality Index. We have the National Sanitation Foundation Water Quality Index. We have the Oregon Water Quality Index. And we have NEMERO's Pollution Index, also known as Raw Pollution Index, and many more. Now, for example, if we take weighted arithmetic index method and as use it to calculate water quality index, the value you will get will fall within this range. And from there, you'll be able to categorize the water quality status as being excellent, good, poor, very poor, and unfit for consumption. Number two, if, for example, you use water quality index based on NSF water quality index, so the result you will get from this method will fall within this water quality range. And the water quality status will be categorized as very bad, bad, moderate, very good, and excellent. And number three, if you use the Oregon water quality index method, the water quality index you will get will fall within this range. And from there, you'll be able to categorize the water quality status into very poor, poor, fair, good, and excellent. And similarly, if you are using the CCME water quality index method, the water quality index value you will get will fall within this range. And the categorization of water quality status will fall within these categories as well, like poor, marginal, fair, good, and excellent. So we can see that the method you use determines the categorization of your water quality status. Similarly, the range of water quality index is also a function of the method you use And also, one thing to note about water quality index is that water quality index takes into consideration all the parameters under investigation or selected. That means it's not just using one parameter to make decision. No, it considers all the parameters or many parameters in question and summarize everything to produce the water quality index value for which you'll be able to categorize. And the categorization of water quality status also based on the method of water quality index you have adopted. So in the next video, we are going to see how to calculate water quality index using different methods. Thank you for watching.